Welcome back to Afternoon Express. It's Friday, and we're about to make it so much better for you. When Aluta's journalist sister is killed for her investigation of a mining conspiracy involving her own boss, Aluta must fight to stop the corruption and bring her sister's killers to justice. This is the storyline of Uncovered, a riveting new movie produced by Thandeka Nodada, set to be released in cinemas on the 30th of August. You have to go and watch this. She joins us now with Dumisani Mbebe, who acts in the movie, to tell us a little bit more about it. Have a look at this.
I want to give Makuza mine back to the people. That means that you get to nationalize a mine and win an election.
America! America!
If this deal goes through, it will ruin the people of Somkel. Don't you see it?
You need to stop pretending you care about the people.
In the eye, I told you, you've got nothing to do with what's going on.
Did you let her blindside us? Whose side are you on?
Yours. Oh, yours? The company's, okay?
Well, then act like it, okay? You're not the only young, black, talented thing out there.
I mean, if that's the trailer, what on earth is in the movie? Wow, that's intense. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
I mean, when I look, I just see awards all over there. Wow. So, this is well done on this being your first.
Yeah, thank you.
Your future looks bright.
Thank you so much.
How did you happen upon the story?
Oh, man. So, it was created by my husband, Zuno Dada. Sure. So, he came up with the story. He started reading about the mines, he started reading about the king of oil. And then, funny enough, we went to this gentleman and he said, here's the idea, just put it on paper because he writes very well.
Yeah.
So, and then I just love the fact that, you know what I mean, it's an action thriller led by women. So I said, yay, let's push this.
So you wrote it, like you were part of the writing team, and wrote it as well.
I still remember the first day he came to me with the story. He said, listen, we actually don't have you know, action thrillers in South Africa, and like if we do, they're not really shot that well.
Yeah.
And then he said, listen, just put together a quick synopsis, one pager, and I knew that he really wanted to do this, so I just quickly, you know, put something together and I sent it to him, and to see.
You know what's so thrilling about it, and what's so scary, I suppose, about it? We've got so much material for thrillers at the moment in South Africa. You just have to write what's really going on in some spaces, and it's thrilling. Mm. So, to put that all together in a film, but also because it is based on the mine, I mean, did you have to do a hell of a lot of research?
It was a lot of research. Like I said, my husband started going to mine Indabas. We had to go to Newcastle, because that's where we shot it.
Yeah.
And we went to this place called Blobosch, and that's where the actual story takes place. Because when we saw how the community was living, the illegal mining and the fact that the mines are not rehabilitated, so we said, okay, we're going to set the story here. I mean, there's a saying that says when two elephants fight, I mean, it's the grass that is damaged. So when you go to that community, then you understand the essence of our movie.
You know, when you look at a big hit film, there's always maybe one, two super actors. But the casting of this is just extraordinary. Like, literally everyone in this film is a big hitter. So did you do the casting as well?
Yes, I did.
Obviously. Tell me about who you chose and why you chose them.
So when we wrote the script, so Stephen Pilmer is the one who ended up writing the script. I looked at it and I knew what he can deliver.
Yeah.
So obviously with him, it was just a phone call. Dumisani, I needed to be a killer. And then obviously I've always admired Robert Hobb's work.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So he's always in small roles, but I mean, to see him in this movie, you're going to just be blown away. And then obviously Thandiwe Goroge, I've always loved her work as well. So I only auditioned the lead actress because for me, I needed somebody who's not really a celebrity, somebody who can just play a role of being naive at first, but actually can kick butts later.
But her scream in that one scene is so haunting.
She is amazing.
You are never going to forget that scream.
Her cry.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Oh.
She goes there. Even the audition.
Yeah.
I met a, you know what I mean? So I had a martial arts trainer on the audition.
Yeah.
So I needed to see, can she punch, you know? So
she
also
can punch.
I made her cry, you know?
Yeah.
How is her cry? Because a lot of people think, hey, if the tears go down, then I'm good, I'm crying.
Yeah.
But with her, it touches your soul.
Yeah.
It really
She's
is.
She's made me cry, and that's just the trailer.
Yeah, it is amazing. And I was acting with her, you know what I mean? So I played the journalist that dies. And when she was crying, holding me, I think we stopped shooting for like a few minutes. We all were crying.
Oh.
And she is that amazing. She connects, and that's what I loved with her. She connects with the character. She takes it seriously. I mean, she went for martial arts training for 2 months before we shot the movie.
Incredible.
That's how disciplined she is.
Please, can I be you when I'm big? Like, performing, to producing. What was it like wearing the two hats, the producing hat and then acting in it as well?
I don't think I'll ever do that again. It was insanely crazy.
Yeah, you hate free time, clearly.
Yeah, so I'm in the office, I'm talking money, I'm talking to our sponsors, and then, Thandeka, you need it on set. I'm like, oh, okay, the script. So it was too much, but, you know, I said I'm going to do a good job with this movie, so I was not going to compromise in on my acting and producing.
Yeah.
But I'll never do both again,
sure.
But I managed to push. And also, my character dies quickly, so I'm like, okay.
Now, Dumisani, for such a good guy, my goodness, can you play a bad guy?
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
It's for me, any actor, this is the kind of character any actor dreams of.
Yeah.
You know, if, of course, they're not, you know, thinking about being the next Ridge Forrester or something like that. Nothing in between.
Yeah.
For me, I mean, it would be easy for someone to say, no, it was easy for Dumisani because he understands the character. He was involved from the very beginning of the movie.
Sure.
But then you step back and then there's just you and the character and then the respect that you need to actually, you know, give that character so that you can portray
him. Tell us
him
about him.
His name is Mnata. Basically, Mnata is a gnat, you know, loosely translated. Basically, you can never get away. There's no way that you're going to get away. If Mnata is after you, he will get to you.
Yeah.
She said earlier, she dies early in the movie.
Yeah.
No, she doesn't die early. She gets killed early in the movie by Mnata. Basically, Mnata is the henchman.
Yeah.
He does all the dirty work for the actual antagonist, which is played by Robert Hobbs, beautifully so. He's your go-to guy. He doesn't do a lot of talking. He takes out people, basically.
Oh, so scary. I wish I had more time with you. But quickly, before we go, I want to know, what is the timeline of a film like this? So it's going to be released now on the 30th. Everyone in this country is going to watch it.
Yes.
And then, so it's going to be on cinema. Then what happens? Does it go internationally for all the festivals and awards? Or, like, where does a film like this go?
Okay, so firstly, we've already done international festivals.
Okay,
so we've been to LA. It's been a semi-finalist in London.
Yes.
It's currently in Canada right now and next month. Is going to Michigan.
Oh.
So, I mean, there's still life after that.
Yeah.
So, obviously, it's also just licensing it and selling it overseas.
Incredible. Best of luck. Why should everyone in South Africa watch it, other than the fact that it's brilliant?
I would say, if there has ever been a relevant movie in the current state of affairs in terms of like our political climate, this is the movie everyone is talking about. We want our land back, but you need to ask yourself one question. What is it worth?
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Mm. It's a relevant, irrelevant movie. You walk away with something. Also, you also walk away proud. You just watch amazing actors just playing, you know what I mean, great characters.
Yeah.
You take away something from there. And the fact that it's led by a strong, powerful woman.
Yes, baby. I can't thank you enough. You know, from the pit of your soul, you are just creating such beautiful work. You are truly an inspiration. Thank you for just being such a legend. Oh,
thank you so much.
I couldn't be prouder and I couldn't celebrate you both more.
Thank you so much, Jeanette. Thank you.
For having us.